Today, we're going to take a look at conditional probability. This type of probability is all about finding the odds of something happening, given that something else has already occurred. Let's start with a refresher on basic probability. The probability of something happening can be expressed as the number of desired outcomes divided by the number of total possible outcomes. Here's an example of a basic probability problem. There are 10 marbles in a bag. 3 are blue, 3 are red, and 4 are orange. What are the odds of pulling out a red marble? To solve this, we place the number of desired outcomes on the top. In this case, it's 3 because there are 3 red marbles, and the total number of possible outcomes on the bottom. This is 10, since there are 10 total marbles in the bag. Seems pretty straightforward, right? Well, conditional probability adds a bit of a twist to this, as the objects or people in question often have more than one possible attribute. So let's look at an example problem with more than one possible attribute. Out of 100 houses sold, 50 had a garage, 40 had a pool, and of these, 10 had both a garage and a pool, leaving 20 houses with neither. Given that a house had a garage, what are the odds that it also had a pool? What do we do with all of this information? If we show it as a Venn diagram, we can make more sense of it. We can now see the overlap between the houses sold with garages and the houses sold with pools, all within the larger set of houses sold. It's easier to see now that of the 50 houses sold with a garage, 10 of them also had a pool. So the odds are 10 over 50, which can be expressed as the fraction 1/5, or 20%. I'll take those odds. Fortunately, there's a faster way to do this than drawing a Venn diagram every time you encounter a conditional probability question. There's a handy formula we can use. We read this formula as the probability P of event B happening, given that event A has happened, is equal to the probability of events A and B both happening, divided by the probability that event A has happened. In these types of problems, both probabilities on the right side of the equation are usually given or can be determined from a sentence or table. So in our example problem, the P of A and B is the 10 houses that were sold with both a garage and a swimming pool out of the 100 total houses. This fraction, 10 over 100, can also be written as 1 over 10. The P of A is the probability of a house being sold with a garage, event A, which is 50 houses out of the 100, or 5 out of 10. Now that our formula is complete, we can divide 1 over 10 by 5 over 10, and we get 1 over 5, which is equal to 20%, just as we figured out from our diagram. Let's try one more with numbers that aren't quite so neat. In a small town, there are 216 men. 144 of them have brown hair, and 56 of them have mustaches. 24 of the men have brown hair and mustaches. What are the odds that a man chosen at random has a mustache, given that he has brown hair? Let's plug these numbers into our formula. The probability of event A, brown hair, and event B, mustache, is the 24 men with both divided by the 216 total men. The probability of event A is 144 divided by the 216 total men. We divide 24 over 216 by 144 over 216 using fraction division. The 216s can be canceled out, so we are left with 24 over 144. This fraction can be reduced to 1 over 6, or approximately 16.67%. All right, that's all for this review. I hope this increased your odds of understanding conditional probability. Thanks for watching, and happy studying.